Hey there, I hope all is well. I wanted to take a quick minute and share an article from September 29th. And you know, something stood out to me when I read the words organic. And so this is from Bloomberg, and it gives a good idea as to how the mainstream media and how they're trying to reword and using the same language that the Federal Reserve Board clearly have constructed behind the scenes. Because within this article here, we have a quote from Jerome Powell that uses the word organic from a prior meeting. Then there's also a Fed governor that talks about the word organic. So clearly they've been working on how to spin off this current monetary policy implementation, which seems completely opposite of what the word organic mean. Because when I hear the word organic, I think about natural, no artificial intervention, things of that nature. But yet what's currently going on up until October 10th with this whole repo situation of supplying liquidity for the money markets by purchasing treasuries is not necessarily an organic ordeal. But yet I'll thumb through some of this here, share my thoughts. And as always, you can find more details below. But a lot of things here stood out to me and I want to just highlight it briefly. But it says Fed backs organic balance sheet rise. Wall Street wants a whopper. And so it says they say it's better to eat organic. But when it comes to the Federal Reserve balance sheet, Wall Street is hungering for a lot more. Financial analysts argue that the Fed needs to buy anywhere from $200 billion to $500 trillion in Treasury securities to bulk up its balance sheet and reduce the rise of money market turmoil. So such a massive operation would seemingly be far bigger than the organic balance sheet growth that many Fed policy makers are currently talking about. So just the fact in quotations, organic balance, clearly is not organic. And when you scroll down and look at the current graph here that shows their balance sheet, we all know that this prior hump to the left of the screen was not organic. It was an artificial injection of them deciding to go out and purchase every single thing to provide liquidity to keep the system from imploding. And so they literally propped this thing up for the past several years through the quantitative easing process. And now it looks like what they're being called to do is to increase this balance sheet in an organic way. And so the fact that the prior increase of the balance sheet was artificial, now it's going to be organic. And so it says policymakers have sought to push back against any notion of a return of QE by portraying any restart of asset purchases as a natural response to the economy's increasing demand for currency and liquidity. And so just the idea of it not being QE, but yet being something, being a natural response to the economy's increasing demand. I wonder whether there'd be a demand for increasing currency and liquidity if this system in and of itself wasn't designed upon debt. And at this current moment when a lot of people are not as profitable as they should be, what's needed? I guess they need some extra liquidity. They need a boost, a jump start, more of the same thing that got us into this problem in the first place. Scroll down some more here. So it looks like coming up at the end of this month, there's going to be another FOMC meeting, of which, according to the article here, a lot of people on Wall Street, a lot of institutions are expecting to hear some good news for them. And the problem is, once that process begins officially in an organic way, what's going to keep them from having to continue to do that when things actually slow down eventually and they are forced to buy those things to keep things propped up even longer? So once again, like a lot of people have already said, that once QE starts, there'll be no stopping. And clearly they're trying to find a way to spin this thing off in a way that it can be sold to the American public in a organic fashion to keep the public from actually questioning their current policies, even though this spells nothing but trouble. Because once again, if they couldn't unwind their previous balance sheet, and it caused a pinch or a squeeze in the money markets from there not being enough liquidity, that means from this point on, Wall Street will be solely dependent upon easing policies from the Federal Reserve, purchasing everything. And then it's just going to be a matter of time before some of that, as I always say, happens to spill over to the main economy, reach that 2% inflation that they always been wanting, or more likely exceeding that by a lot. So here's the very last quote I'll share. It says, it's, quote, very possible that reserves are near or approaching their appropriate level. Philadelphia Fed President Patrick Harker said on Friday at an event in New York, if that is the case, we may need to resume the organic growth of the balance sheet earlier than anticipated. And then the very last paragraph, it said, he stressed, though, that wouldn't mean the Fed was launching another round of quantitative easing. Quote, this is not QE4. Let me make this clear. This is not a monetary policy tool. So this is not a monetary tool. How do you explain the prior event of the increase in the balance sheet? That was supposed to be a monetary tool. So I guess this is just something they're going to try to spin off without having to use the words monetary toolkit, because it's going to be considered organic policy is what they're going to try to spin off. But once again, when they tell us this is not QE4, I always tend to read the opposite of that. So definitely this is some form of easing. And so they want to call it organic easing, probably not quantitative easing. But anyway, thought I would just share this. This is definitely some interesting stuff, because it's saying Wall Street is begging for a lot more, closer to something around the lines of $1 trillion worth of extra liquidity into the market. And the last time that type of funds were brought into existence, it was during the recovery process after a major crisis. And so if they're in need of close to $1 trillion now in a so-called good economic expansion, imagine when things really slow down and they're going to need several trillion. So just something to think about. But other than that, let me know your thoughts down below. And definitely if you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up and share this. All right, talk to you later.